Hi, my name is Wilnan Ziada, New York City-based director and creator of theater, television, and film, and also a proud Phoenix Global Artist Ambassador. Today, I am thrilled to be speaking with Beijing's acclaimed contemporary painter, Li Hua Xiang. For more on Mr. Li, you can read more about him right below this video. But in the meantime, here is my interview with Mr. Li, and I will also be joined by the wonderful, on translation, Ellen. Well, good evening from New York City, and it is morning time in the East, in Beijing, China, to be specific. I'm so excited that once again, we have Ellen on translation, and today's guest is the acclaimed contemporary painter, Li Hua Xiang, but he said that I can call him Hua Xiang. Good morning to you. Good evening to me. Hua Xiang, my first question for you is, you are such an incredible painter, and I'm curious to know when you realized that you had not only such a love of painting, but that you would pursue it professionally.
大家早上好，现在是纽约的晚上，然后是北京的早上，然后今天我们请到了很著名的当代画家李华向老师来参加我们的采访。李老师早上好，然后那个您是一位非常棒、非常出色的画家，然后我想问您的第一个问题是，您是什么时候意识到自己对于绘画的热爱，或者说您是什么时候意识到愿意把这个当做自己的事业？您问的这个问题。可能是大部分走上画画这条路的人，走上艺术这条路的人，都会有感触的一个问题。应该是这样说，我从小就特别的喜欢绘画，但是我成长的那种环境呢，就是极少能接受到很好的一个美术教育，所以在我童年一直到青少年这个阶段，基本上都是自己凭借自己的一个兴趣，然后处于一种自学的状态。然后我非常正式的学习绘画，学习美术基础，应该是从高中的时候，后来也就是因为自己比较努力，很顺利的就考上了一所大学，但是我完全走入一种职业化的一个状态，一直要在相对比较晚的时候，我是2001年到2005年读的，在大学读油画专业。但是我完全的从事绘画创作应该是2008年，也就是相当于毕业过后了，已经两三年之后了。因为刚毕业的时候，因为在中国这个环境下，就是从事绘画艺术这个专业的人找工作就业是非常难的，所以刚毕业我就来到北京，学习了一段时间，关于动画软件的制作，然后并且在动画游戏工作了两三年，很久。但是内心一直有这个想做一个职业画家的这个梦想，直到了2008年，相对于，我的个人的经济能力，稍微好转，并且我偿还了我大学读书的时候所欠下的这个一些费用，欠下的学校的和亲戚的一些费用，然后我就比较，有这个胆量和有这个毅力辞去我所在的工作，然后专门。去到了北京的当时的一个小的画家村，叫索家村和费家村，这两个村是挨着的。当时我就在那里，找到了我的师兄，大学师兄，他们在那里，已经进入了所谓偏职业化的这么一个状态。我就在那里是正式的，从事了所谓画家这条路吧。谢谢。
Hello, Will, Director Will, it's very nice to meet you. And I think your question most people who are doing artists or who are becoming artists will have connection to your question. I started to love painting when I was very small, probably just a couple of years old. I had interest for it, but because of family reasons, there wasn't the education environment. So when I was very young and as a teenager, I nearly self-taught myself. And when I received final formal education on art, it was in high school. So, and I worked very hard to get into an artistic university. And when I decided that it would be my profession, it was kind of late. I was in college learning art from 2001 to 2005, but it was only until 2 to 3 years later in 2008, I decided that I wanted to make it my professional, because as an artistic graduation in China, it will be very difficult to find a job for someone who is a painter. So after I graduated in Beijing, I found myself a job as an animation software worker, something related to animation. That was about 2 to 3 years. And it was in 2008 when I didn't have that much financial difficulties. So I paid back the money that I owed for university. And that's when I had the courage and the persistence to decide that I want to make art my profession. So I went to Suo Village and Fei Village. I met some of my previous students who are older than me in my college. And they were already making it a profession. And that's when I walked on my path to make it my job.
Wow, that is so incredible. And you mentioned two words that I think any artist out there now more than ever needs to hear, that with courage and persistence, you can make your dreams come true. And you, my friend, have done just that. I want to know, amidst all of the incredible solo exhibitions that you have had over the past decade, are there a few that stand out for you?
李老师，您刚才提到了两个特别棒的词，一个就是勇气，还有就是一个毅力。我觉得这个是所有人需要的，才能让他们的梦想变为现实。然后您完全做到了这一点。就是我还想问您的一点是，就是在过去的十多年里，能举办了很多的展览，尤其是个展，就是有没有哪个展览是让您印象特别深刻的？好的，首先谢谢吴亚导演，我想。 对于我来说，印象最为深刻的应该是我的第一人生的第一次画展。第一次画展当时是在七九八的一个，北京的七九八的一个不是很大的一个空间。那个个展上展出了我，在2015年到2017年。 这两三年当中的一批的纸本创作，和几件尺幅偏大的油画布上绘画作品，也就是我给您传的我的个人介绍小视频里面的那种那个前部分那个入境系列，在那个个展上主要展出了我这个系列的作品，也。 相对的来说，可以说就是这个系列的作品是我从事绘画创作很多年，逐渐摸索出一种，相对比较成熟、比较有个人面貌的，这样的一个绘画风格的一批作品，在这个展览上。 当时有很多朋友，身边的朋友过去给予鼓励，并且有所交流，基本上就是这样，谢谢。Thank you,
Mr. Will. If you ask me what is the most the exhibition that I had the deepest feeling, it must be the first exhibition. It was in Beijing 798 Art Street. It was a space that is not too large. In the exhibition, there was my works from 2015 to 2017. There were oil paintings and as well as other paintings. And if you can see my personal video, the one that I sent you, the front part of that is these kind of paintings. This was a series that I feel that I'm more mature with, and it can show my personal style. In this habitation, a lot of my friends came over to encourage and to communicate me, and that's what impressed me.
That's wonderful. And we will definitely be showing that video at some point throughout the interview. But also other things that I want to show throughout the video are some of the beautiful paintings. One behind you, the Tiger Mountain painting, we will be showing a high resolution picture of. We also are going to be showing an eagle stands on a high mountain. Also, we're going to be showing your painting, The Lonely Bird Looks Back, and your painting, The Homeward Journey. Of all your paintings, my friend, you have such a beautiful outlook and perspective on animals and nature. You have such a beautiful, singular, elegant, moving emotionally, a moving perspective on animals and nature. Where does that love of animals and nature come from?
非常感谢您李老师，就是我们肯定会把您的那个视频放出来，然后我们还会放您的一些话，然后他说的是英文，所以我可能不太确定明确中文是什么，就是那个鹰的那个，还有就是那个孤单的鸟，还有就是回家的路程还是回家的旅途，然后还有就是他发现就是您对那个画的那个描绘，就是对动物还有对自然有一种非常
非常优雅的进行了一种动态的描绘，就是他想请问一下您对那个动物还有对大自然的热爱是什么？的确，像乌雅导演说的，我的很多创作里面有非常多的那个关于自然的一些元素，比如在荒野当中的一个小动物呀，或者是直接描绘一些植物，花花草草。 甚至有些题材就是直接画了几棵树，我想应该是这种对自然的这种喜爱之情，应该是和我的一个成长环境，有不可分割的一些关系吧。我所出生的这个安徽舒城县是位于安徽的西部，它属于大别山脉的一个延续。 我家乡的这种自然环境呢，基本上可以说是一种以丘陵地带为主，平原极少的这么一个环境。我从小生活的这个小镇，也是不是很发达。就是在中国这种城市化特别进程的过程中，恰恰我所经历的一些，都是和自然和乡村乡野。 非常关系紧密的这么一种童年生活，在我的印象中，我童年总是去河里游泳、摸鱼，然后去山上采蘑菇，或者是爬树等等，就是那种生活，可能是今天很多。 生活在城市里面的，包括我的孩子这样的，他们都特别难以体会，也难以产生那种共情的，这也不得不是我有时候的一种感慨。回到创作上来说，我的创作虽然分了好几个系列，但普遍的。 都是和这种自然环境和风景产生极大的关系。在我刚从事绘画创作的这个阶段，差不多是我来到北京这座超级大都市生活的几年之后，也就是在这种城市异常拥挤、异常忙碌的这种都市生活里面，我产生了一种特别。 因为一种不适应产生了很多情感上的一种反应，包括对故乡环境的这种思念。但是我深深的知道，就是从事艺术创作，北京是最好的一个去处。在我的老家虽然自然环境这么优越，但是对于绘画可以交流、可以学习的，并且可以做展览展示的地方都少之又少，几乎说没有这个条件。 这也是我不得不放弃家乡的那个那样诱人的一个环境，来到北京从事创作的原因。可能我 绘画里面的这些应该都是和我以往过去的这些经历有关系，另外和我个人的这种对于传统绘画的这种热爱，比如西方绘画的当中的这种风景绘画印象派啊，包括更早之前的一些蜡笔画派，包括英国的这个透蜡这样的风景画家都十分的喜爱，对于中国传统的山水绘画我也是十分的热爱。我想主要是这些原因导致的吧，谢谢。
Okay, thank you. As you can see in my creations, there are a lot of nature. I think this is because, of course, I love nature, animals and plants, and sometimes maybe it's just a few trees. I think this is because of my growing up environment. As you can see, I was born in Anhui, Shucheng, in the west part, and there was a mountain there called Dabie Mountain. It was mainly a mountain landscape, and there was few of plain lands. So when I was in a small town, it was not too developed, and there was very strong country feel. So I would go swimming in the river and catch fishes in the river, or climb the mountains, climb the trees, pick up mushrooms in the mountains. And when I went to live in this kind of life is very difficult for someone who lives in the city to imagine, even probably my own child, they might unable to experience that, and they might be unable to share the common feeling. And when I started, so that's when in my creation, there are a lot of sceneries, there's a lot of nature and landscape. When I just began to work as a professional artist, I came to Beijing, and it's very large cities. So in the busy life here, I had, I wasn't accustomed to it. And I had that kind of emotions that I miss my country land. But if I want to do artistic creation, Beijing is the best place because there are people to communicate, there are places to learn from, and there's exhibition opportunities. So I had to give up my hometown and come to Beijing to work on my creations. So in my painting, I think there's past experience contained and there's a love for tradition. And I have moved by very different art types, like the West Impressionist part. And like in UK, there is this famous painter. And I also love traditional Chinese mountains and waters paintings. So I think these are what moved me.
I love that. Well, you say that you left your hometown, but I could feel your hometown all over the paintings that I have been so privileged to witness, even just through your website. And hopefully one day I'll get to see them in person, like the one behind you. Mr. Li, your heart and your love of your hometown is seen all throughout your work. And it is an inspiration to me as an artist about the power and the universality of emotion. And you express it so beautifully and singularly through your artwork. And I am so grateful for your time and the time that you took today. And I look forward to meeting you one day in person when I one day make it over to the East. Thank you.